So the first thing that we need to do in R is we have to set the working directory, the folder that contains the R data folder. That will be the easiest for doing all the stuff that we're going to do in the demo. So not the R data folder itself, but the folder that is on top of that. So to set the working directory, you go here to the Files tab and you click these three dots and then you go to that folder. So in my case, it's this one. In your case, it will be something else, but you go to the folder that contains the R data folder. And then you click open. And now it's opened here, so you should see the R data folder. And you click here on set as working directory. So more, and then set as working directory. And then if you want to check if he has done a good job, you just run the get working directory function. In all the paths that I use here to open files, I have included the R data folder. So that means that if you want these paths to work when you open files, that you have that the working directory should be the folder that contains the R data folder. But if you take the R data folder as your working directory, then you simply have to do this and it will work also. But then you have to adjust the paths in the demo script. So the demo script starts with a whole bunch of code. So the first, 22 lines, you don't have to look at them now. This is for the exercises. So if you're going to do the exercises later on, you have to run this part of the code. So you just select all of it and you click run. It's not for now, in the demo we don't use it, but in the exercises you will need all these variables that you're creating here. There are thousands and thousands of functions in R, so I can really not give an overview of all of them. That would be really boring, so I focused on the ones that I really use regularly. And I'm going to show you in R. That's the most useful thing, I think, to do. So let's start here. So first of all, I'm going to make a vector. So here we are, we have a vector with integers 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So there are a lot of mathematical functions in R. I'm not going to give an overview, but on the cheat sheet you can find an overview, and also in the tutorial, so the Word file that you have with the exercises, there is an overview of the most used mathematical functions in R. So these functions, they typically work on everything. They will work on vectors and they will work on tables. So an example is the log function. So you have the log function itself, that's the natural log. You have log 2, that's the log base 2. And you have log 10, that's the log base 10. So you can do it on the vector. And of course, what it will do, it will work element-wise. So it will calculate the log 10 of every element. And the result is a new vector with the log transformed values. All the mathematical functions, they work on vectors. They will also work on tables. They will do exactly the same thing on a table. So if you do log 10 on a data frame, it will calculate the log 10 of every element in that data frame. Now, some functions, they will work differently on vectors and on data frames. And an example of such a function is the length function. So when you do length on a vector, what it will do is it will generate 5, the number of elements in that vector. So the vector has 5 elements, so length of v is 5. Now, when you do length on empty cars on a data frame, what it generates, can take a look here, is 11. So what does it count? It's not the elements, because empty cars is a big data frame. It has a lot of elements. So what it counts, it's the columns. And that is typical behavior for many functions. They work on elements in a vector, but on data frames, they work on the columns and not on the elements.